Deputy McGrath, on behalf of Fianna Fáil.
Thank you very much, Ciarán Cúrla. Tánaiste, now that the latest Exchequer returns and the quarter two economic data have been published, we are entering a period of intense political negotiations around the budget, which will be announced in 12 days' time. Fianna Fáil fully accepts the imperative to continue to reduce the budget deficit until we get to the point where the Minister of Finance of the day is able to stand up in this House and announce a balanced budget. People welcome any evidence, Tánaiste, that there is an improvement in the economy, but I think you will be the first to admit yourself that they're not seeing any evidence of that yet in their daily lives. They're not seeing it in their pocket, and the truth is that they won't for some time to come, because any recovery in the economy will be gradual, and budgets will be tight for a number of years yet in this country. In this budget, we believe it is possible to achieve our deficit target while also protecting vital areas such as education, mental health and disability services. This will not be easy, but it can be done. It is about minimising the inevitable damage inflicted on an economy when you take more money out of it, while at the same time protecting the essential public services that people rely on. Above all else, Tánaiste, this budget must be fair. And unlike the last two budgets, its impact must be progressive in nature. As you know, the ESRI independently verified that the last two budgets disproportionately affected those on low and middle incomes. Those people cannot afford a repeat of that in 12 days' time. The Minister for Finance has now confirmed that the budget adjustment will be somewhat less than the anticipated €3.1 billion. I welcome this, Tánaiste, and now it is about getting the budget right in terms of the overall adjustment figure, and perhaps...
Sorry, hold on a second. Would you please, without interruption, thank you.
And then finished. Yeah. The Minister for Finance has now confirmed the adjustment will be somewhat less than €3.1 billion. I welcome this, Tánaiste, and it is now about getting the budget right in terms of the adjustment figure, and perhaps even more importantly, about the detailed budgetary measures that will be contained therein. In various interviews, Tánaiste, you have stated your view quite strongly on a number of occasions that the adjustment should be no greater than is necessary to achieve the budget target of 5.1% of the deficit. In other words, that no more will be taken out than is absolutely necessary. Is that still your view, Tánaiste?
Thank you. Tánaiste.
Well, first of all, can I acknowledge what Deputy McGrath has said, that first of all, that the economy is recovering, and I do acknowledge that I think many people have yet to experience that in their own lives. We are seeing an increase in employment, 3,000 additional jobs per month. We're seeing a drop in unemployment. The figures, the live register figures this week, showing the level of unemployment at its lowest level since 2009, now down to 13.3% from a high of 15.1%. We're also seeing improvements in areas like construction, for example, over the course of the last year, 11% increase in construction activity. Probably more significantly, I think, the fact that we're seeing an increase in the number of planning applications, up about 37% last year, all of which is indicating that we're seeing improvement. In relation to the budget, the Exchequer returns show that Ireland is now on track to meet our targets in 2013, with tax receipts on profile and expenditure under control in the year to the end of September. And I think that this highlights again the consistent improvement in the management of Ireland's public finances by this government. The Exchequer deficit at the end of September 2013 stood at 7.142 billion, which is 4 billion lower than the same period last year. The tax base is growing, with just under 26.9 billion in taxes collected this year, which is up 768 million on the same period last year, an increase of almost 3%. I think more significantly is that income tax receipts are up by 400 million last year, and given that there was no increase last year in income tax, I think that reflects the overall increase in the number of people who are now at work in the economy, and VAT is up by 80 million, I think, reflecting an increase in retail activity. I have said from the beginning of public discussion in relation to the broad budget issues that I believed that it was possible for us to meet our target this year by doing an adjustment in the budget of less than 3.1 billion, which was the figure which was being advocated to us by many commentators. The Minister for Finance confirmed that yesterday, that it should be possible to meet our targets this year by doing an adjustment of less than 3.1 billion.
Thank you.
You're right that the budget discussions are at an intensive stage at this stage. They obviously won't be completed until right close to the budget, and at that stage we'll have a final figure for the adjustment.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Kieran Corlett. Well, Tánaiste, if you parse the words that you have said there, that is a change in your position, because you haven't just been saying all along that the adjustment can be less than 3.1 billion euro, but you have been saying all along repeatedly and in very clear terms that the adjustment should be no more than is absolutely necessary to achieve the deficit target that we are required to achieve. That's what you have been saying. Now, I still don't know what that figure is. That figure could be 2.5 billion, it could be 2.7 billion, but you haven't just been saying that it should be less than 3.1. So can you advise the House, if that is still your position, that the adjustment should be whatever is required to achieve the deficit target and no more of an adjustment? I think it's important that you confirm that to us. And the fundamental point I want to make in relation to the composition of the budget is that it must pass the basic test of fairness. The last two budgets, in my view, have not passed that test. You will never get a consensus on what is fair. But I think the best measure is whether or not the impact of the budget is progressive and that the burden of its measures is carried by those most able to carry it. And that was not the case in the last two budgets. So is your position still no more of an adjustment than is required to achieve the 5.1%? And will this budget pass that basic test of fairness, which the last two budgets did not?
Thank you, Deputy. Tánaiste.
Well, first of all, I think there's one thing certain about this budget, Deputy McGrath. Whatever is in it, you and your party, and I think the opposition generally, will oppose it. I think that's pretty certain. So, you know, let's start with that, that, you know, we're now, I think, entering the political... Yeah, of course, yeah, and that's politics. You know, I think what we're now entering is the political discourse on the budget, and that's fair enough. And you know, you're not going to.
No need for the chorus. Thanks.
You're not going to tempt me to tell you what the budget figures are in advance of the Minister for Finance and the Minister for Public Expenditure and Reform making their statements to the House. The position has not changed. No, the position has not changed. What we have to do here is we're on track to exit the bailout programme this year. We know we have a deficit reduction target to meet. We have to meet that target. We know that we are seeing recovery taking place in our economy, and you know, we can all look at the figures that support that. We have to make sure that recovery is not put at risk, that we continue to meet our targets, that we do a budget that meets that, that ensures that it continues to support employment, that it's directed at getting people back to work, that it is fair. I reject entirely your assertion that the last two budgets were not fair. There were measures.
Over time, thank you.
Well, I mean, it's a bit rich.
Because we're over time, so it's a bit, please let the Tánaiste finish.
It's a bit rich coming from Fianna Fáil. When you signed up to an agreement at the end of 2010, which prescribed what would be in the budgets for the subsequent 3 years, and we had to... It is true.
Sorry, Tánaiste,
you go back and revisit. I mean, the utter hypocrisy now. The utter hypocrisy.
Sorry, hold on. Deputy.
really doing it? Please try and restrain yourself.
You signed up to an agreement in 2010, which prescribed what would be in the budget. We had to change that, and now that we have succeeded in getting us to a point where we're exiting from the bailout, where we're seeing the economy recovering, it's as if you want to wipe history clean and pretend that you never had hand, act, or part in the mess that we inherited in the first place.